station of Malard.
और दोस्तों,
स्वागत है आपका
यहाँ जहाँ है गांव और शहर,
यहाँ जहाँ है अनेक गाड़ियों की लहर,
मछलियों की मस्ती है
और हसमुख लोगों की बस्ती है।
आओ जरा कहानियों के इस बिल में मेरे,
यही है मलाड, यही बसता हमारे दिल में।
Polarized in the 1992 riots. Moreover, you can find St. Anthony's Church in Malwani as well, which is even older than Our Lady of Lourdes Church in Orlem. Moreover, if you venture ahead of Aksa Beach, you will find a relatively lesser known vital landmark, that is the Malard Fort, aka the Mud Fort, which was captured by the Marathas from the Portuguese in 1736, and it overlooks the Arabian Sea. Coming to some more interesting facts, Bombay Talkies, which is the first movie company to be established in Mumbai, was established in Malad by Himanshu Roy and Devika Rani. And today Malad is a railway station in the Western Suburb line of Mumbai, and also it is sometimes known to be named so because of the mines of Malad stone in the area.
St. Anthony's Church is located en route to INS Hamla. It is a Grade 2A heritage structure. The present building was constructed in 1834 to 1835, although its origins can be traced back to the 1680s. The former building was reportedly destroyed thrice during the Maratha invasion. A life-size statue of St. Anthony was imported from Portugal. The tiles on the roof were brought from Mangalore.
The Mall with Infinite Experiences. This is the second Infinity Mall in Mumbai, the first being at Andheri. The mall was first launched in Malad on May 2011. It is one of the biggest malls in Mumbai. Infinity Mall has a variety of showrooms. What makes Infinity a unique mall from the other malls is that it has a fully functioning roller coaster within the mall itself.
But not everything is happy in Malad. There were two incidents that shook Malad. One, the wall collapse, and second, the fire at MM Mithaiwala. MM Mithaiwala is the most famous sweet shop in Malad. The best part about this shop is that it is right outside the station. Malad Mithaiwala has customers coming from all over the city, especially for their famous jalebis and many other delicacies.
On 29 May 2018, a fire broke out at MM Mithaiwala, destroying a lot of property. However, there were no casualties that occurred.
At Pimpri Para in Malad East, the wall of an educational institute collapsed. The main cause of this incident was heavy rainfall. 21 people were killed and 78 injured after this devastating incident. Taking into consideration the problems of the people, here are the redevelopment plans we came up with. Roadside hawkers are one of the major causes of traffic and congestion on roads. In order to control this problem, specified areas should be provided for the roadside vendors and hawkers. This will reduce the hindrance in traffic. One of the best ways to do this would be by creating shopping centers where the hawkers can set up their stall at very low rents. Flooding of drains is a rising issue in Malad. During rains, the drains in Tank Colony and other parts of Orlem get flooded. It has taken a toll on the health of the local residents. There should be a concrete system for the effective maintenance of drains. Proper maintenance of the drains and drainage system may prevent clogging in the drains.
Was among a group of islands that lay to the west of the Salsette Island. Earlier, Marwi remained separate from the mainland. The Indian Navy operates a logistics training establishment called INS Hamla on Marwi. St. Anthony's School is located on the way to Marwi. It is a school run by the priests of St. Anthony's Church. It was established in the year 1900. This is Malvani Church. The designs on the walls of this church trace back to the British era. A major part of the beach is occupied by the Indian naval base, the INS Hamla. The beach is not safe for swimming due to the presence of very swift currents and sinking sand.
Malad is a land of diverse cultures. The people who initially lived in Malad were the Kolis, the Bhandaris and the East Indian communities. They are recognized as the official initial inhabitants of Malad. Malad is a very vibrant city which has rural as well as urban population living together in one city. This feature makes Malad very unique from the rest of the cities. A large part of the population of Malad earn their income through fishing and farm-related activities. Fish drying is done on a large scale in Mud Island. People also earn their income through ferries which connect the islands of Manori and Gorai to the mainland. Currently, Malad has a population of over 15 lakh. In this documentary, we have interviewed people from all professions and stratas of life.
What is your name?
My name is Ashley Dilima.
And what is your age?
My age?
Yes.
60.
Oh, so from where are you from originally?
I'm from Mumbai, sir.
Oh, you should live here only?
Yeah.
So you were born and brought up?
This is my native place.
Oh, this is your native place. Yeah. Okay, so now you've lived in Malad like since a very long time.
Yeah.
So what is the hardest part about living in Malad?
Hardest part is traveling.
And what is the best part about living in Malad?
The best part about living in Malad, there are beaches, beautiful beaches here, as well as it is a holiday spot, you can say. There are beautiful bungalows with the topmost companies in Bombay, which are in Bombay, have their bungalows only at Malad, nowhere else.
And what is your best part about Malad?
My best part about Malad is the beautiful scenes in Malad we have. I don't think you'll get that scenes which are in Malad, in the interior in Malad, I mean. Like Mud Island, Erangel, Aksa, these are beautiful places to visit.
Now, if there is one thing you would change about Malad,
what would that be? What you could change or you would tell somebody else to
change? Yeah, to do today is the traffic.
That is it. Yeah, yeah. You know. So like what would you suggest? Anything to reduce the traffic?
Reduce the traffic now since 3 days back, I came to know that there's a metro going to come to up to Marvi village.
Yeah, till Marvi village?
Yes, till the cross. So I think if that is there,
yeah,
then it will be a very good thing for the people to commute from here.
And if you had a chance to go out of Malad, would you go to settle out?
No, today especially no, because this is, I think, the only place in Mumbai that is so peaceful, so quiet, so
yes,
loving and so clean.
Hello.
Hi.
You all stay in Mumbai only?
Yeah.
Yes. And where
we
in Mumbai
stay in Yeah, we stay in Pune.
And where in Mumbai are you all from?
Andheri.
Andheri,
Borivali.
And
I'm in Pimpri Chinchwad.
Okay. So you have come to Mumbai for?
Just for 2 days.
2 days. Yeah. So all of you all are tourists to Malad this time?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So what is the thing like you all like especially about Malad?
About Malad, if you see, we have a temple here, mm-hmm, which our family goddess is, Durga Devi.
Mm-hmm.
And then we wanted to visit this fort.
It's a beautiful fort, right?
Beautiful fort, so we wanted to visit it.
Malad is the only place where you see urban life and rural life.
How do you all feel coming back to your hometown?
It's very nice, it's lovely, so we have come here.
You all feel very, all your memories are all come back.
Yeah.
If there was one thing you would want to change about Malad, what would that be? Anything that will want
Nothing,
to
we wanted to be this way.
Be this way. You like Malad the way it is.
Yeah.
Last stop, Aksa. Aksa Beach is the most popular tourist attraction in Malad. It is a famous weekend destination. Aksa Beach also happens to be one of the cleanest beaches in the city.
They say, oh my God, I see the way you shine.